Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Minecraft video, I'll be showing you how you can edit a Minecraft texture using Photoshop Elements, place that into a resource pack, and then install that resource pack back into Minecraft. Okay, let's get to it. If you've already watched my previous video on creating a custom Minecraft resource pack, then you're already at this point, which is where you need to be. If you are not at this point, then go back and review that video. And there's a link for that. There's one right there on the cards, and there's also one in the description. What we need here is the assets folder, and we'll also update our pack.png file right there. We'll go into the assets folder and Minecraft, and we'll take a look at the textures at the bottom right down here. So open this one up. And then take a look at block. Just bring that up. And here are all the blocks inside of Minecraft. And I need to keep the names the same, so the best way to do this is to simply open a block up and then edit that block and then save it back into the same location. That way Minecraft knows what it is and where it's supposed to be. I'll just scroll down here. We'll find dirt since I have my test wall set up with dirt already. And there it is right there. So let's open up this file. I'll just drag and drop this from this folder over into the Photoshop Elements program, and there we go. And these are very, very small file sizes, as you can see here. The reason for that is because Minecraft graphics are at a very low size and low resolution, so that the game can run very quickly, even though it has a lot of complexity in there, and also run very well on smaller and limited computers. Let's see what size this is. Go up here to Image, come down to Resize and Image Size. And here you go. This has a width of 16, a height of 16, and it's at a resolution of 72. It's a very, very small block. Let's just zoom in on this. There we go. In a later video, I'll be showing you how you can increase the resolution and get some more detail out of these things. But for this one, let's just quickly see the process on doing a basic edit. We'll keep this real simple. Again, I'm just going to change the color on this. So let's go up to Enhance, come down to Adjust Color, and Adjust Hue Saturation. And let's just make this thing kind of a green color. There we go. That's kind of nice right in there. So it's now kind of a green dirt instead of regular dirt. Choose OK. File. We'll save that. Saves back to the same location. Choose Save, Replace Existing File, yes, and then OK. And there we go. Okay, that file's been saved, and we're back into our block folder. And this is our little floating folder here. Let's just back up a little bit. I'll go back here to Assets, and then back out to the Resource Pack right there. Let's take a real fast look and make a change here on our PNG file. Bring this into Photoshop Elements. There we go. And we'll just change the background color on this cat. We'll do it real easy. I'll just make a selection of our background color and then Enhance, come down to Adjust Color, Hue Saturation, and let's give this thing a different kind of background color in here. It's got a nice bright blue. There we go. And let's just deselect that. And I'll save this back on the same location again. I'll do it the fast way. Just click that and we'll choose Save as it is closing. And there we go. Okay, that's all taken care of. Let's now close out Photoshop Elements, and there's our new icon. We've already changed the one file here inside of Assets. Let's now combine this one and this into a new zip folder. Click on our first one, hold the Control key down, click on our next two, right click, and just like in the last video, go to 7-zip. And then add to archive. And I'll call this one cat5, just keep things consistent here. Cat5 and OK. And let that then combine all of that into a new zip file. Once we have that combined, then we'll quickly pop this over into Minecraft, load in the resource pack, install it into Minecraft, and let's see how it looks with that new dirt change in there. And again, these are the basic steps you go through whenever you're changing a graphic inside of Minecraft. The fanciest stuff, of course, is all of the artwork you'll be doing for those graphics, but this is the basic steps to actually get it installed and over into Minecraft. Okay, back to Minecraft again. Let's click on the play button, and I'll let this launch Minecraft in here and give it a second to bring up the Minecraft launcher. And there it is. Okay, come down to Options and Resource Packs. Open the Resource Pack folder. There it is. Let's go over here. We'll grab our new zip file right there and right drag it over here and choose Copy. And there we go. Okay, that's all done. Let's get these out of the way. Choose Done. We'll have to reinstall this, reload this again. So click on Options now, Resource Packs, and there it is. We just went through that same process again, back to the screen, go to Options, back to Resource Packs, and there's that new resource pack. Okay, let's click on this one and click on the little arrow right there. And that brings it over. Notice how it brings it in, puts it on the top location. So this now is the active resource pack. Also notice where it says My Resource Pack. We talked about changing that name in the previous video on making your basic resource pack, your custom resource pack. Okay, once it's done, just choose Done. Let it relaunch Minecraft here. I'll get back to our load screen. Choose Done. And let's just go full screen on this. There we go. Single player. Go back to our test one here. And as soon as this loads, we'll see that the test wall is going to have changed now from brown dirt over to that new green dirt. And there you go. There's that new green dirt right there. Let's just go ahead and walk over there a bit. And there it is. There's that green dirt. So it's that easy to edit a texture inside of Minecraft and then put it into a new resource pack, install that resource pack, and there you go. You're all set. Again, the hard stuff is all now out of the way. We've taken a look at all of the tricky stuff. Now we can get down to the nitty-gritty of doing some interesting looking different textures and designing a whole look and feel for Minecraft using Photoshop Elements. And if you're working with a different graphics program aside from Photoshop Elements, I'll be covering this in a couple of other programs as well. I'll be showing this same basic discussion in Adobe Photoshop and also the same basic discussion over in the GIMP program. So we have those three different ones. It's all basically the same stuff, but I'll show it in the three different programs. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button, and of course, don't forget to subscribe and to share as well. And if you want to learn a lot more about using the different graphics programs like Photoshop Elements or Adobe Photoshop, take a look at my channel. I have hundreds of videos on how to use those graphics programs along with complete training courses, and you'll find a link for that right down there in the description.